President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says the national government has pre-positioned some 2.88 billion pesos worth of aid as Typhoon Carina continues to batter parts of the country. The National Capital Region and other parts of Luzon have been submerged in floods after Typhoon Carina, enhanced by the southwest monsoon, brought non-stop rains since Tuesday. Mr. Marcos says he has instructed all concerned agencies to provide swift assistance to those affected. He adds, over the last week, government has already provided more than 43 million pesos in aid to over 770,000 individuals affected by the southwest monsoon in the Visayas and some regions in Mindanao. Mr. Marcos is scheduled to hold a briefing with the State Disaster Agency, the NDRRMC, to assess the current situation in the country. Now, bad weather battering parts of the Philippines. The country's Disaster Management Agency verifying reports 8 have died due to the combined effects of the southwest monsoon, which is enhanced by Typhoon Carina and Tropical Cyclone Buchoy. Now, all of the fatalities reported to have come from Mindanao. The storms have already affected nearly 180,000 families, displacing about 7,000 of them. Meanwhile, initial damage to agriculture has been pegged at 80.7 million pesos, while damage to infrastructure was estimated at 700,000 pesos. At least 4 are reported dead following a landslide in Agoncillo, Batangas. The landslide buried a home in Barangay Subic, Ilaya. Agoncillo Vice Mayor Daniel Reyes says the body of a pregnant mother and 3 children aged 9 to 15 have been recovered. Floods also hitting several parts of the Philippines due to torrential rains. Some roads remain impassable in Metro Manila due to gutter and even knee-deep floods. At least 49 families have evacuated in Mariveles, Bataan Province, following a landslide. In Pampanga, water levels have reached 4 feet, with residents already using boats to move around.
Tuloy-tuloy po yung pag-ulan kagabi, and of course yung bumababang tubig galing sa upper stream natin, ini-expect na natin na papunta na dito, plus yung high tide. So yan po, compounding effect.
But in Tuguegarao City, farmers consider the rain a blessing.
Malaki ang tulong ng ulan kapag yung ang niya ay tubig ng niya ay mahina, hindi agad makarating.
Now, for work and classes today, Malacañang has suspended both in the capital region per recommendation of the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council. The class suspension in the metro covers all levels. In Congress, work in both the Senate and the House of Representatives were also called off, still as a precaution from the bad weather. The inclement weather has also forced the Philippine Stock Exchange to suspend trading this Wednesday. Aside from Metro Manila, here's a look at the other areas which canceled classes today, July 24. Now, flooding has also been reported in several parts of the Philippine capital of Manila, causing traffic woes. Job Manahan filed this report.
Several riders had to drag their motorcycles in the middle of Taft Avenue and seek shelter after their engines abruptly stopped due to gutter deep floods. Some small cars also had to stop, fearing that their engines might break down due to the flooding. Among those stranded and needed help was Philip Zepeda, a motorcycle rider. He said that he didn't expect his motorcycle engine to break down after crossing the flooded Taft Avenue. One passenger, Marie-Chris, said she had to rent a tricycle for 250 pesos to ensure her welfare and safety on the way to a bus terminal in Quezon City. Marie-Chris said she was trying to catch her 5 a.m. trip to Pangasinan but said she might be already late due to the delays caused by the heavy rain. Gutter deep floods also hit the front of the Manila City Hall, España Boulevard, Doton, and Wakam Rotonda. the Office of Civil Defense said that as of 4 a.m., red rainfall warning is up in the areas of Metro Manila, Cavite, and Bataan. This means that residents must expect and be prepared for possible flooding, heavy rains, and landslides.
Let us get an update now on the flooding situation in Quezon City from our correspondent, Jesse Cruzat. Jesse, go ahead. What can you tell us?
Yes, Stanley, good morning. As of this moment, Council of Barangay Rojas, Quezon City, and other volunteers are already feeding the evacuees and rescued families here in the Barangay Gymnasium. As of 9:35 this morning, numbers of evacuees from three evacuation sites in the same barangay has climbed to more than 600 individuals, according to Barangay Chairwoman Mary Dayan Regalado. Meanwhile, Stanley, the rescue operation has been going on within flooded areas, especially in Waling-Waling Street, where flood level reached the roof of some houses. Quezon City DRRMO, the Bureau of Fire Protection, the Philippine National Police and Armed Forces of the Philippines, together with other rescue units, are already deployed in the area. Furthermore, Stanley, a 19-year-old woman has been reportedly drowned but currently in a stable condition now. Barangay Council of Rojas once again appealed to the national government to send them additional assistance such as food, medicine, modular tents, and any form of help. And that's the latest from my end. Back to you, Sam.
All right, Jesse, I just want to ask a few questions. What are the immediate risks that you're seeing? You're in Barangay Rojas right now reporting about this. What is the situation of those residents that are continue to be threatened by rising flood waters?
Yes, Stanley, as of this moment, one of the major problems that I am seeing right now is the congestion of the number of families that are present here in the Barangay Gymnasium, because according to the Barangay Chairwoman, only limited families can be accommodated inside of this evacuation center. That's why they were able to have two more evacuation sites in the barangay. One from the Holy Parish of the said barangay, and the other one is in an elementary school.
Okay, you mentioned that the local authorities there are calling for assistance from the national government in terms of getting all those residents at risk out of harm's way. And we also know for a fact that Barangay Rojas in Quezon City has always been flood-prone. Now, what have you been hearing from authorities about their projections for the rest of the day, and what are their plans?
Actually, Stanley, as of this moment, a while ago, I've seen some trucks and some units of the rescue operation units of the PCDRMO that has been helping the barangay to go to those flooded areas and rescue some residents that were trapped in their houses, most especially to those low-lying areas where most of the families or the residents are already on the roof of their houses, Stanley. As of this moment, the Barangay Council of Rojas are still waiting for other relief or help from the national government, such as medicine, food, and any form of health care.
Okay, possibly we'll be seeing more forced evacuations in the next couple of hours as, the weather continues to pose problems. Has there been a problem in terms of forcing people to evacuate, especially in homes that are really prone or vulnerable to a worsening scenario of floods there?
Yes. Actually, one of the things that I noticed here is that some of the residents are already informed. Actually, they already started evacuating since yesterday, and most of the people here just left their houses yesterday, and some of them were actually rescued just today.
Okay.
But as to the information dissemination, the Barangay Council has already informed their constituents to evacuate as soon as possible, and they don't have to wait for the flood to reach their residence or houses.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much, Mr. Jesse Cruzat, for talking to us about the situation there in Barangay Rojas in Quezon City. Stay safe. All right. Moving on. The flooding in Luzon also causing havoc on the North Luzon Expressway. The NLEX Corporation has announced the northbound and southbound sections of Valenzuela and Mekawayan, Bulacan, northbound are not passable. Several toll plazas have also been temporarily closed. Meanwhile, one of our correspondents is now in the thick of chaos along the North Luzon Expressway. Let's talk now to Jervis Manahan about the situation there. Jervis, good morning. What can you tell us?
Yes, Dali, we're here in the North Luzon Expressway or MLEX, and we are on the way to Bulacan, but we are stuck past Balintawak toll gate for already 2 hours because the vehicles are not moving. The part of Valenzuela, both southbound and northbound, are flooded and not passable to vehicles. The NLEX management announced in an advisory on their social media pages that they are already pumping out the water. And they are already setting up U-turn slots so that vehicles can go back to Balintawak. But Mikawayan and Valenzuela are still flooded and some toll gates are already closed. We have really barely moved since before 8 o'clock in the morning, and rain is still very strong in the area. So we are seeing really a Carmageddon. There are a lot of vehicles stuck here, and they are barely moving. And they are hoping that water will be pumped out eventually so that they can proceed to their destination. So meanwhile, we have not yet seen a working U-turn slot so vehicles can go back. Stanley.
Okay, just to clarify that situation you're reporting to us, Jervis, is it the NLEX itself that's flooded or the exits into some of the areas along NLEX, particularly those in Bulacan and Valenzuela, which you mentioned, are already flooded?
Well, based on some that we have seen, I think the main parts of NLEX are already flooded based on their advisories. Both the southbound and northbound of Valenzuela are already not passable because part of the actual expressway is already flooded, plus the exits here in Bulacan are also flooded as well. So I'm not yet sure how vehicles can exit and can make their way out of this situation because right now thousands of motorists are stuck here.
And I don't know the extent of the advisory of NLEX that they have given to motorists, but have you heard of any plans as well to even close the entry points just so to avoid congestion in the main thoroughfare?
So far, we have not yet received an advisory about closing the entry points except for some of the toll gates along the North Luzon Expressway that have already been closed. These include some in, I think, in Paso de Blas, and in Mikawayan. So, it's from their advisory, Marilao southbound, Tikwat and southbound, Lawak northbound, and Paso de Blas northbound are already temporarily closed because of the situation. Meanwhile, Valenzuela northbound, southbound, and Mikawayan northbound are still not passable to all types of vehicles, so even the large vehicles cannot pass through because of the water.
All right. And having experienced that yourself at the NLEX, what is your advice to our motorists who may be planning to still use the NLEX at this point?
So I think motorists should just go for their own safety because a lot of motorists are up here right now. Vehicles are moving and they have been for hours. So I think the management should figure out a way to manage this situation.
All right. On that note, Jervis Manahan, again, thank you for reporting to us about the situation. The North Luzon Expressway, Jervis was telling us that the highway itself is flooded and there's a traffic jam in many of the exit points, particularly in the areas of Bulacan and Valenzuela. We'll try to get more updates and we will even attempt to get the statement from NLEX advising motorists to avoid NLEX as of the moment, as you know, the floods continue to affect most of the areas there, particularly the area from Balintawak up to some of the exit points in Bulacan. We'll give you more updates on this as they develop. Several villages in Kawit, Cavite are submerged in floods due to the non-stop rains. Let's get an update now from our correspondent, Ganiel Krishnan. Ganiel, good morning. Go ahead.
Yes, good morning, Stanley. Well, several barangays here in Tawit, Cavite remain submerged in flood waters Following hours of continuous rain brought about with the intensified southwest monsoon influenced by Typhoon Karina, areas such as Barangay Gahak, Barangay Marulas, Tabuntu, and Wakas 1 are currently experiencing gutter deep flooding, causing distress among residents. Now, as of 10 a.m. today, the situation has escalated with over 1,000 individuals seeking refuge in evacuation centers due to the rising waters. You know, the Cavite Municipal Social Welfare and Development Office has been actively responding to the crisis, providing essential aid such as food, water, and temporary shelter to those affected by the flooding. Stanley, you know, here in Cavite, Cavite, this is actually referred as to the catch basin of Cavite because whenever there is rainfall, the area tends to experience flooding. This is primarily due to upland flooding where water from higher elevations flows down and accumulates in lower-lying areas like Cavite, Cavite, Noveleta, Rosario, and Cavite City. That's the latest update here in Cavite, Cavite. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Ganiel Krishnan. Ganiel telling us about the floods in Cavite, Cavite, described to be knee-deep in a lot of areas there. 1,000 residents have been affected, and the Municipal Social Welfare and Development providing aid, food, and even temporary shelter for residents that need to flee their homes as of the moment. Ganiel was also describing to us that Cavite, Cavite is, in fact, a catch basin. It is often flooded when severe weather conditions occur. Power distributor Meralco rushes to restore electricity supply in areas affected by Typhoon Karina. It said 23,000 customers are now affected by power interruptions in Metro Manila and in parts of Calabarzon, as well as in Bulacan. Now, the outages are mostly due to flooding in the affected areas. Meralco says it will deploy teams to flooded areas as soon as the waters subside. It also urges customers and consumers to follow safety measures to avoid untoward incidents amid the worsening weather. So let's get an update now on the southwest monsoon and Typhoon Karina from Pagasa weather forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica. Go ahead. What can you tell us?
Good morning to you and to all of our audience at ENC. So as of 4 a.m. today, the center of the eye of Typhoon Karina was at 290 kilometers northeast of Itbayat, Batanes, with a maximum sustained winds of 155 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness up to 190 kilometers per hour. It's moving at northwestward direction with a speed of 25 kilometers per hour. And because of Karina, we have a tropical cyclone wind signal number 2 raised over Batanes. Signal number 1 is raised over Babuyan Islands, the northern portion of mainland Cagayan, and the northern portion of Ilocos Norte. And because of Karina, we're also expecting heavy rainfall. So we're expecting for today 50 to 100 millimeters of rain over Batanes and Babuyan Islands. Furthermore, the southwest monsoon enhanced by Karina will also bring moderate to intense rainfall over various localities in the western western portion of Luzon today through Friday. We're also expecting Karina to leave the Philippine area of responsibility tonight or tomorrow morning. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Okay, Veronica, when you say it is leaving the Philippine area of responsibility, there's no guarantee that the rains would stop right away, at least not tonight. Are you expecting wet conditions to persist in the next couple of days?
That's right. So although Karina is expected to leave in by tonight or tomorrow, it is still going to enhance the southwest monsoon. So by tomorrow, we're still expecting moderate to heavy or with at times intense rains over here in Metro Manila. Although by Thursday, although we're still expecting rains, but not as much as from Monday through Thursday.
Okay, Manila seems to be the area that is severely affected by rains today. But what about Visayas and Mindanao? Can they expect better weather now, at least as soon as Typhoon Karina leaves?
For Western Visayas, we're still expecting rains to persist over the next few days. This is due to the southwest monsoon, but it's not as much heavy rains like in the western sections of Luzon. And for Mindanao area, we're now expecting better weather conditions where it's only partly cloudy to cloudy skies. Although there are still chances of localized thunderstorms, mostly in the afternoon and in the evening.
All right. On that note, Veronica Torres of Pag-asa, thank you so much for giving us the weather update for today. Veronica there was telling us about the exact location of Typhoon Karina now, which is 290 kilometers northeast of Itbayat in Batanes, but storm signals remain, signal number 2 in Batanes at least, and signal number 1 in the Babuyan Islands, as well as mainland Cagayan and northern Ilocos Norte. For the rest of the country, Pag-asa was saying the southwest monsoon has been enhancing the rains brought about by Typhoon Karina, and this weather pattern may exist until the rest of the week, at least for Metro Manila, while Visayas and Mindanao may see some improvements in the weather. Now, Typhoon Karina is expected to exit the Philippine area of responsibility by late Wednesday to early Thursday morning. And we'll try to get regular updates here from weather forecaster Pag-asa about the track of the typhoon and the kind of weather that we can expect in the next couple of hours. And it's not just here in the Philippines. Taiwan's even bracing for the arrival of Typhoon Karina, known internationally as Gaimi. The first storm of the season to affect the island, Gaimi is expected to make landfall on the northeast coast early evening on Wednesday. Work and school in Taiwan are suspended across the whole of the nation. The Transport Ministry is also saying almost all domestic flights have already been cancelled, along with 27 international flights out of Taiwan. Taiwan's Defense Ministry has placed its forces on standby now, ready to assist with disaster relief efforts. Currently categorized as a medium-strength typhoon by Taiwan's weather agency, Gaimi is forecast to move across the Taiwan Strait and then hit the southeastern Chinese province of Fujian late afternoon on Friday.